I think we can start now, and I would like to welcome our guests of today. So Mauro Piermaria from the Italian Space Agency and Giuseppe Saccomandi from the National Group of Mathematical Physics at TINDAL. And then we will have also Gabriella Pinzali from the University of Padova. We will have Andrea Milani, Space DISO. And finally, Susanna Terracini could not come today, so she recorded a video, and we will see also a video of presentation of her ERC, which, all the other people, supported the school. So it is. So let me say that I want to join what Giovanni was saying today. That is, we are very proud to have organized this school because, first of all, let me say. We realize that we don't know many of the people which are in the room, which is a good point. That is, there are many young people that are attending the school, and this is in itself a success of the school. We wanted to organize a school in celestial mechanics since several years, but you know there was the crisis, and we didn't succeed to have funds in the last years. But now we had this opportunity, which we joined to CELMEC, and let me say that we would like to do it on a regular basis, if not every 4 years, maybe even every 2 years. So this is a wish also of the committee of the Celestial Mechanics of the International Astronomical Union. And let me say that this school was organized thanks to the support of the sponsors, which were listed today. Let me say it again. Please, Giovanni, correct myself if I forget somebody. So these are the from the organizers, the University of Pisa and Tor Vergata, which have a long tradition in trying to train young people in celestial mechanics and astrodynamics. And then we have the universities of Padova and Torino through Gabriella Pinzali and Susanna Terracini, who both have ERCs, so very excellent projects related to celestial mechanics. And then we have a Space DIS from Pisa that will be presented by Andrea Milani. We have the support of the European Space Agency and the support of the INDAM, Istituto Nazionale di Alta Matematica, and of course the support of the Italian Space Agency that we kind of acknowledge for allowing us to organize this school. So this will be a presentation of different activities, and I think we think that it will really give the feeling of what is going on in celestial mechanics and astrodynamics under different perspectives. So not only academy, but also space agencies, which is of seminal importance for our world work. So let me thank the first speaker, who will be Mauro Piermaria from the Italian Space Agency, who will present the activities of the Italian Space Agency. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Sandra, and good afternoon, everybody. Let me say that as soon as we heard about the organization of this school, we fully supported this, because as Italian Space Agency, we really appreciated this organization, because also I see a very international partner here. So as one of the main points of the Italian Space Agency activity is the education, and we put a lot of resources on that. This is one of the few things that we support every year. So today I want to make a short presentation about, in general, actually I want to present as well the Italian Space Agency, because many of you are not Italian, but I want to show you what Italy does for the space. Italy is a very important country for the space business, being the third country that launched a satellite in the early 1960, after US and the Soviet Union. So I want to give you a look at what who we are, what we do, and some insight of what we are going to do in the next future as for the space business. As a first thing, I want to launch a video. It's an institutional video. Text is in Italian, but images are international. So, okay, it's possible to turn off the light for a couple of minutes. Is there anybody here who can do it? Much more easier sending somebody on space.
Calling mathematicians to tell them to turn off the light.
Okay, we can do it with a light. Right? It's Okay, doesn't matter. We're going to launch the video. Then. Windows Media Player, because before it was working Windows Media Player. Okay, we are going to skip also the video. We are going to the presentation. It's not working anymore. The audio.
La presentazione.
Ma il video non è diventato radio.